This video is going to show you how to use the SEO for Webpages widget. When you open up the widget options, the section that automatically opens is webpage. If you are building responsive websites, the webpage section is really the only section that you're going to need to edit. You can edit these other sections, but as long as you're building responsive websites, all you'll need to edit is right in here. For those of you that are building adaptive websites, which means that there is a tablet and phone version of your website, I will show you at the end of this video what you need to do with this widget. So at the top of this section, it says the page title and URL are automatically generated. So the widget is now able to grab the title and URL that will come from the page properties. So the way to change any of this is you right-click on the page, go to page properties, then inside the options tab, you'll be able to change the page title and the URL. By default, the page title and URL follow whatever you put into the page name. So if you put the page title into the page name, you're not going to have to adjust anything. This applies for every page except for the home page. You're not able to change the URL of the home page. It's always going to be index.html. A few tips on what to enter in for the title is make sure that the title is unique on each page and that the title is no more than 60 characters. For the purpose of this example, I'm just going to enter in a demo title. Awesome page for awesome people. And then see, it automatically generates the title for you. Then you click OK. Now we'll go back over to the widget. And the first section that we need to edit is the image. The image should be at least 600 pixels wide and at least 300 pixels tall. Make sure that the image represents the page and uses as few words as possible. I recommend using an illustration or a stock photo, and a quick way that you can find an image that you would use in this section is just go over to Google and type in whatever you think would represent the page. And so since I set the title as an awesome page for awesome people, I'm just going to type in awesome people. Then go over to images, then go to search tools, usage rights, and click labeled for reuse. And then in the size, go to larger than 800 by 600. Then see, this is a great example of an image that I can use. I'm going to name that one awesome. Then you just go back over into Muse, add the file. And there we go. Now we have our image. Then this next section is for Fancy. Fancy is a newer social media that's kind of a mix-up between Pinterest and Etsy. You have 13 options to choose from, and if none of them match what your page is about, then you can always choose other. And lastly, you have the description. The description should be no more than 160 characters. It should clearly describe the page. And it should use text that people might be searching for. So if this widget were on a page that was called SEO for web pages, someone might be searching for ways to get traffic flowing to their website, how to improve in ranking, and social media preview. So the description that I have in here covers those three general things that people could be looking for. So to make the description consistent with my page title, I'm actually going to go back into the page properties and type in SEO for web pages, free Adobe Muse widget. Click OK. We'll change the image too, so it's not showing someone breakdancing, because that wouldn't make sense for SEO for web pages. So now I'm going to publish the site. I just want to show you everything that this widget generates just by entering the little amount of information that you have to enter. So if you right click on the page and then view page source, I'm not sure what it is for other browsers, but it's probably something similar. So with the little information that you have to enter into the widget then takes that information and generates over 20 lines of SEO markup. So it generates everything from here to here. That's pretty awesome. So if you're building responsive websites, then you now know everything that you need to know. If you're building adaptive websites, then I just need to show you this very last part. So for an adaptive website, I'm just going to make an alternate layout. Then under copy from, you want to copy from desktop and click everything. You want it to copy everything, then click OK. Now go back into the widget. Under version, switch this to desktop. Now just copy the widget and then go to the alternate version of that same page, open it up, and paste the widget on that page. Then switch the site version to phone, and then you're good to go.